So tonight is the 1 year anniversary of the Flying Fluffy channel. 1 year ago tonight, I got in my van all pissed off about the Gabranson trade and the Panthers losing, and filmed what turned out to be an epically bad, or good, meltdown. You know, the good old days, before I shaved myself bald. But since then, we've had a ton of fun, haven't we? We've had the yoga guy, and Carlos, and magic with Matthias. Heck, we've even had celebrities. We sang Christmas carols with John Oates. We've had Rocky Balboa. And we've even had Steve Goldstein interviewing Rocky Balboa. It's crazy. We've had Jaws and cooking with Jaws and Yager. Lots of Yager. And that crazy Russian spy guy. What about him? He's been a blast. And of course, this summer, Crazy Bill was born. And apparently, his little cousin got in on the action as well, Frankie, and Frankie Jr. And of course, we've had this guy, the 300-year-old vampire.
What's your name?
My real name is Martin Hector Villanueva Jovanovski Goldstein.
But more than anything, the entire point of the channel was two parts. The Florida Panthers, and of course, Fluffy. Now, some of you have asked why I named the channel Flying Fluffy, and I guess eventually I'll have to make a video explaining that. But not today. Today, we got the Red Wings, and really, we just need 2 points. We've got to keep it going. We've won a game, lost a game, won it. Wait a minute. This is starting to sound awfully, awfully familiar.
Relax. It is okay. We can still make the playoffs. In fact, if you do the mathematicals, winning 2 and losing 1 over and over and over and over again, no matter how bad the loss is, we can still make the playoffs, my friends. Yes, we can. Yes, we can.
Hey, Panther fans! It's been a year. 1 year ago tonight, I started this whole mess, and I've had a lot of fun, and I just want to say before we get into anything else, thank you everybody for watching and subscribing and tweeting and retweeting and sharing on Facebook and every other way that we're getting this out. The guys from Panther Parkway with Frank and everybody. Just big thank you. Couldn't have done it without you. Could not have done it without Fluffy, my kids, and the whole deal. But that's enough of that. We're moving on. So we might have some special guests coming up every once in a while. And that's one of the things I've been thinking about. If you look back at my older stuff, it was a completely different format, and I love the new format. Don't get me wrong. I'm having a lot of fun, especially with the introductions. But I've also kind of had a gnawing at me to maybe include some of these people that helped us, that helped me get where I am, right? So every once in a while, maybe during an intermission, I don't know, you might see somebody else come in and take my place. Just saying. But tonight, Red Wings absolutely need 2 points. Had to keep it going at home. We won the first game at home stand, so you really need to start thinking about getting on a roll and winning 2 or 3 games at a time here to kind of get out of the little bit of a hole that we've buried ourselves in. Because of some injuries, we've got a guy coming up, Ballsy, I don't know, I'm just going to call him Balls. That's pretty easy, right? Pretty low pickings. But we need to get 2 points tonight, guys, okay? So we're going to move on. And apparently, the weather down there is pretty bad. What, rain and buckets? Is it rain and buckets of octopus, though?
I talked to the group of businessmen that went down to Mexico to buy that octopus almost 3 months ago. They kept it in a tank of water that long just for the playoffs. Now that's playoff planning, guys.
All right, so we get out of the period, 1-0 Red Wings. Pretty good period of hockey. A lot of stuff going on. Fun things. Yandel and Ekblad got into, I wouldn't exactly call it a fight, but it was still kind of funny watching both those guys get tough on the ice at the same time. And we had a little issue there with the power play. This stupid face-off rule, man, with you know, if he had two violations, then it ends up being a penalty. And that's a totally subjective thing that the refs can and can't call. Basically, like holding in football. You could call it on almost every face-off. And to call it on the face-off right after a penalty, and we're already short, to give the other team a two-minute five-on-three, that is just crazy, insane stupidity on the referee's part. But we kill it off, and offensively, we look good. Look, Owen Tippett, the kid is ready. Absolutely no reason to send him down. I don't think that that's going to happen. I think he's up to stay. The top line, Dadonoff, Barkov, Huberto, they are figuring it out, man. And as the season gets on, those guys are going to be scary, scary good. Especially Dadonoff as he gets used to the game. But, so like, it's only 1-0. Like, I've said it a few times now, we have not had an overtime game yet. So, let's move on to the second period. What is going on? Ekblad, Petrovic, you look like a couple of blind ballerinas doing the cha-cha. You know, you go ahead and you go in there and you go in there and we're looking good. And oh, look, the puck is behind us. You guys, come on. You got to get it together a little bit. Just a little bit. Like a Dadonoff and Barkov and Huberto. These guys, they're beautiful. Right? Okay? So look, we're going into the third period. It's tie game. It's not so bad. The refs are screwing us all night, okay? Alright, let's just say it right there, okay? The referees, they're stealing bananas from the tree and they frying them in the pan, but they're using like canola oil. They're not even frying it in coconut oil like you're supposed to, making it taste good. They go, no, here, have some cheap canola oil, you know? Or maybe even the worst, that's soybean. It's terrible shit. So look, we're going to go to the next period and hopefully we can come back and we got to get 2 points, because if we don't, I don't even know who's going to show up. This guy just, he give me off the street and say, hey, come do a video. So that's why I'm here. So let's move on, eh?
We are going to overtime!
And 1 point. So, disappointing way to end the game. Fun game to watch, obviously. And that 3-on-3 overtime period, I know a lot of people don't really like that, but I love it. It's just fun. It's just pure fun. Those guys get so exhausted. And now, maybe you could just change it and take away the shootout and just keep playing 3-on-3 until somebody scores or somebody dies on the ice, whichever one comes first. So those guys were out there almost the whole time and dog tired. But James Reimer, Jimmy Howard, too, both these guys, hey, they both played their asses off tonight. It was really well-played game all the way around. Disappointing, obviously, not to get the 2 points. But, hey, look, we kind of keep pace, you know. And I know some of you fans are going to say, oh, you know, that's it. You know, you have to win a game like that. And I don't necessarily disagree. But Detroit came in desperate, and we played well. Top line, that's really my thing tonight, guys. The top line really looks like it's gelling. Dadonoff was out of his mind tonight, and so I'm happy with that. You know, we still got to clean a few things up, but moreover, most nights, if we only give up 2 goals in regulation, this team, most nights, we're going to win. So look, we're going to come back Monday against the Lightning again, and got to pick it back up, obviously, and get a big 2 points, especially beating Tampa. That would be nice because they're obviously playing out of their minds right now. Okay, guys, so look, thanks for watching. Happy 1 year, and I guess it makes sense. 1 year and 1 point.